Every year, Elite Model Look scours the globe in search of the hottest new modelling talent. From Argentina to Zambia, no stone is left unturned.
Can we just interrupt you for 2 seconds?
The winner from each country will travel to stylish Shanghai to train with world-class coaches and top models.
Go back.
And finally, to compete against each other in a stunning show for all the Elite agents who will vote for their top model. A contract with Elite worth $150,000 awaits the winner.
1, 2, 3, go!
Elite Model Management is the biggest network of model agencies in the world and has been discovering and representing fashion icons since 1972. Staying at the top of this highly competitive industry means providing the world's top fashion clients with a constant supply of the world's most beautiful women.
New faces are a very, very important part of our industry. Clients are constantly looking for the next new star. Because of the Elite Model Look contest, we're able to supply all of our clients from Gucci to Prada to Jil Sander, and Elite Model Management is very strong because of the scouting from Elite Model Look.
Elite Model Look was launched in 1983 to discover young, hopeful models from around the world.
It's part of the Elite DNA to deliver new talent, new models every season, and that's what we're great at. I think always finding and sourcing, educating, nurturing, mentoring those kids and launching them into the business.
Its success is legendary. Supermodels Cindy Crawford, Gisele Bündchen, Constance Jablonski, and many others were all discovered by Elite Model Look.
Anyone with one picture can send their application and have the chance to become a top model.
It is one of those most prestigious modeling contests out there. It's like the Olympics. If you do get chosen, it really does open up a lot of doors.
Michaela Koshianova and Ming Shi are just two recent competitors who have found success through the competition. And French top model Noemi Lenoir will help them mentor the contestants.
I've been discovered in 1997 in a post office. I was buying a stamp, and that's the way I start modeling.
Before I scouted by EML, I was at school. I was studying. It was just a normal Chinese student.
Since I was a finalist 2004, I worked for Chanel, Dior, Versace, Armani.
My first campaign was Ralph Lauren, so I was really, really happy because it was shooting by Mario Testino.
I went to Paris to the Fashion Week, then I have my first show for Givenchy Haute Couture.
2 years ago, I shot for the first time, I shot the French Vogue cover, so this was amazing for my career.
Coming up from such a small country, Eastern Europe, Slovakia, Czechoslovakia, it's amazing. Now I'm living in New York and it's so different and I'm glad I'm there.
It's such a beautiful life to be a model that I'm really lucky.
You have to be hardworking and professional, so be ready for that.
Elite Model Look makes an incredible effort to find the most beautiful girls in the world. This year, hundreds of thousands of hopefuls from 60 countries have been through the casting process. Some girls applied through the Facebook app, but for Elite's teams around the world, it's not enough to wait and hope that the next supermodel will come to them.
We have a lot of girls from everywhere. Of course, there are some competition because we want to be the agency that discovers the best girl, you know?
I really want to find a stratospheric, gorgeous British girl who's going to make us proud. We haven't had a British girl going up all the way to the worldwide final and winning it. And this year, I would love to go past the top 50. I really want to find a winner. So just to give you a little bit extra pressure, I want that girl.
Agents and their scouting teams have been out and about, constantly searching for potential models.
Hello, sorry. Can we just interrupt you for 2 seconds?
You can find a girl anywhere. A pretty girl's going to do what ugly girl is doing, you know? She's going to do to school, she's going to go for ballet classes, and she's going to go dancing in clubs, and she's going to go to the groceries.
When you're an agent, you're a scouter. You cannot be just an agent and wait for the phone to ring. You have to be working full-time. heading to the office, to the agency, if you're going back home, if you're on a Sunday evening taking coffee at the street, you know, you have to be always aware of the girls who pass by.
I'm here scouting for a model agency in London called The Leap. Thanks very much.
As well as scouting for girls, open auditions were held in 800 cities around the world. In each country, semi-finalists were selected from the thousands of hopefuls.
My granddad is going to be so proud because he said to me, Heather, you're going to get spotted one day, and now I'm off to the semi-finals.
And from those 60, just 12 lucky girls made it to the national final.
We are spectators of the new future generation of supermodels.
To ensure the girls really achieved their full potential, they were trained and advised on posture and walking from the elite team.
What we've been trying to teach them today is how to be comfortable in their body, and posture is very important because it's about making the clothes look good.
After much deliberation, each region has selected one winner who will represent their country in the Elite Model Look World Final in Shanghai.
I'm just so shocked. Oh my God.
The 60 finalists have started arriving in stylish Shanghai.
Hi, my name is Vladana. I'm from Montenegro. Я вилин свой град за то, що живим близу мора.
For many of them, it's an exciting and nervous first trip away from home, but it's also an opportunity to make new friends from around the world.
Hi, my name is Victoria. I'm 17 years old and I live in Munich in Germany. I want to become a model because I love to travel and I like to meet new people from the fashion business.
C'est la première fois que je voyage en Chine, c'est la première fois que je prends l'avion. Donc pour moi, la chose la plus importante de cette expérience, c'est de découvrir le pays parce que je suis jamais venue ici. De découvrir de nouvelles coutumes, de découvrir un monde nouveau et aussi de découvrir toutes les autres candidates que je ne connais pas pour le moment.
Hello, I'm Juliette. I'm 16 years old and I represent Indonesia. I listen a lot to Latin music and Latin artists because there's a lot of rhythm in the music. And that just makes me want to dance inside.
It's an amazing adventure. I don't know what's going to happen. It's like your dream is very important in your life, of course, and it's amazing when your dream comes true. So.
Most of the elite agents from all over the world will only arrive in time for the final show in 10 days' time. But Michelangelo, Kwok, Jeremy and Erica will act as their eyes and ears, watching and assessing the girls from the moment they arrive until the final decision is made.
And you just arrived?
Yeah. Oh, we just started working. We already started going through the girls. We're looking at the pictures.
Yeah, quickly.
Yeah. We're really excited.
There's some great girls that I can't wait to see in person.
When I look for, you know, when I'm scouting, when I'm meeting the girls, is the natural physics, you know, like how the space of their eyes and their nose and their lips. And after all of that, it is the inner beauty.
What makes a special model or something else? It's something that makes you want to look at her again. And it's not given by just the aspect. It's something that's behind the eyes, it's a sparkle. It's an aura, it's something that about charisma that the model oozes. This is the element that we look for.
The hardest thing is probably going to be missing home. I've been away from my family before, but not for this long and not this far away.
My name is Gillian, I'm 17 and I'm from Britain. My favourite thing about my country is the traditional Scottish music.
Beauty nowadays is so relative. It comes a lot from the attitude, you know. There are some girls that don't think that they will ever develop, but then they can grow and they can shine from the way they look and the way they talk and the way they walk.
I'm really looking forward to meeting his friends because she really looks so beautiful. Friends. One of those girls, yeah, friends.
I think in fashion, beauty is a trend. It's not something that is forever, and it's not something that lasts in the time. It was not the same in the 80s, it was not the same in the 90s, it's not the same now, it's not going to be the same in 2 years. So it's moving a lot and moving very fast, and it's very hard to tell what beauty is and make a point on it.
I think that's one of the things that's really important for me when I look for a girl, is what do they want out of this? You know, a lot of time, these young girls could sit there and say, yeah, you know, I want to be a model because I want to be, you know, I want to dress up. And that's the beginning, yes, but I think that for me, what I want to look for is some type of passion. It's like anything in life, you have to have passion. If you have passion, you're going to be good at what you do.
Modeling, that's why I'm here. I'm hoping to improve my walk, to feel even more comfortable in front of the camera, and to get as far as possible in this competition.
A lot of these girls from the picture, you can see their potential.
Yeah.
And I think seeing them in action and how they are in person really going to help us to make a decision.
Totally.
So I'm so excited to be here too.
Tired, nervous and excited, the girls settle into their 5-star luxury hotel after a long day of travel.
Oh my God.
Tomorrow, their journey really begins. Beautiful girls have flown to stylish Shanghai to compete in the Elite Model Look World Final. After just one night's rest to recover from their journey, the girls must get straight to work and arrive for their first day at Elite's purpose-built training camp.
The boot camp is intensive training. They learn how to walk, they learn how to put makeup, they learn how to pose, they learn how to stand, they learn how to perform, they learn how to interact with people, they learn how to be pleasant, and they get a taste of what the modeling is about.
Also making her way to the boot camp is one of the most influential people in the modeling world. With over 15 years' experience in the industry and 7 years in charge of Elite Model Look, Michaela Godard-Quesada knows better than anyone what it takes to make it to the top of the modeling world.
All of you are young, beautiful girls. All of you are here because you were chosen to represent your country. Now I'm here to tell you, work hard to be the best that you can be, to become an elite top model, okay? You're being judged constantly from agents who have just started to arrive. These people are not only here to help you and to coach you and to push you, but they're also here to judge you. And over the next few days, more of us will be arriving. So, this is your time to shine. There will be only one winner. Okay? See you later.
With boot camp underway, the agents get their first chance to see the girls up close. Before any training is given or makeup applied, every girl must have her picture taken for the catalogue.
Where are you from?
It is the perfect opportunity for Jeremy to get first-hand experience of how the girls react to the camera.
We are looking for the natural beauty of the girl without any makeup, any special hair treatment, just to have to see how she reacts with the light and how she feels in front of a camera, in front of a photographer that she doesn't know. How are you?
Okay.
Okay, try to stay straight in front of me. We have different type of girls. It's very interesting because you can have a really outgoing girl, 20 years old, and then when she's in front of the camera, she's completely shy and she acts weird. And then you have the opposite with a girl who's gonna be 14 years old and standing in front of a camera, and you cannot really explain why. It's a bit like a magic moment.
With so many top class candidates in the group, finding the one winner is not an easy task.
Wow, she's gorgeous.
So Kwok, Erica and Michelangelo will be watching and assessing the girls continuously as they are put through their paces by the training team.
So, give me some goodies. What's happening?
Well, some girls are really interesting, like her.
Yeah.
I like her
a lot.
Very
strong face. And... Do you feel them confident while shooting?
Yeah, it depends which one.
Wow. Wow. Great face. Okay, cool. Can you vote already?
Not yet.
Yeah, much better.
Walking the runway is a central skill for all models.
Okay. Try not to move too much like this, okay? More strong, okay?
Asha is responsible for ensuring that all the girls master this seemingly simple task.
We all know how to walk, but catwalk is different than on the street, right? You have to be the most straight possible, okay? Long neck, shoulders down, like ballerina dancers, okay? And when you walk, like you really push the feet on the floor, so it gives more energy, okay? They need to know how to show with their posture and the way they walk that they're very confident, and it's all about the energy. Some of them, they have to make bigger steps. Some of them, they have to lift more their feet. Some of them, they have to move more their arms or less their arms. Some girls, they just feel it naturally. Some girls, they need to work on it.
The girls are about to get their first experience with a professional photographer. Bojana Tatarska has worked with some of the world's most famous models, and her photographs have appeared in many major magazines, including Elle, Vogue, and Harper's Bazaar. Today, she will be shooting portraits of all the girls.
It's beautiful there. Very nice.
The first photo shoot is a very straightforward shoot. Very simple makeup, very simple lighting, very simple background. It's more about the girl and how the light reflects on her face.
Turn a little bit more this way. Very beautiful. Stay there.
But Jenna and I are trying to see with all the girls the way they photograph first, and then the way they move in front of the camera, the way they react in front of a photographer, in front of a team, and if they listen carefully to what we say.
Yes, that's it. Relax them out. Perfect.
When we look at the photographs, we're looking at like our eyes, the way they look at the camera, the way they don't look at the camera.
We can detect what is the photogenia of the girl, if she's going to be really photogenic or not. They obviously need to communicate and transmit their emotion through their eyes and be comfortable with it.
Yes, really enhancing the pockets.
So we have a portrait, which is all sitting on a chair, and then it's all about their face.
Very nice. So, look, like me, shoulder there. No, it was better before. A little bit more round. Very beautiful. Stay. A little bit chin up. Yes.
Now it's the body shots pictures. So here the girl is moving, so she has to, like, be another character and just dance and move and try different positions.
Perfect. Magnifique. The other one too? Yes. Perfect! Shake, shake, shake. Very beautiful stay. Tiens la jupe comme ça, c'est très joli. Mais avec ce mouvement et cette attitude, très belle. Oui. Magnifique, ok? Les mains sur le mur encore comme tout à l'heure. 10 footers je fais, on a fini. Je veux que tu donnes le meilleur de ça. Mais déjà, ça c'est un très très bon starting point, ok?
Great physical looks are key to becoming a model. But to be a top model, charisma is just as important. The only way for the agents to see if a girl has this special quality is to get to know her better.
You know who I would love to talk to? Yeah. I would love to talk to the Polish girl.
I think one of the girls that actually really I have such a strong feeling for is Poland. She's the girl that I keep noticing. And every time I look at her, she was on her own, either reading or doing something. So finally I went over to her and I'm like, you know, introduce myself.
Hi, Carly, nice to meet you.
Erica, nice to meet you.
When I went over to her, she was drawing and she was a really great artist.
This is your artwork?
Yes.
Wow. May I see? No.
I love that about a girl, just because you know, she has something more than just being beautiful. And also, we are in a creative business. So her being a creative girl, that is something caught my eyes more.
Oh, I love that about her, that she's an
artist. It's incredible. Yeah, it's so sensitivity. Yeah.
The level of the girl this year is spectacular. Incredible personality. Girls really come across strongly. They've got something to say. There's lots of girls with lots of gifts and interests, and they all seem very positive and full of joie de vivre. And I think that's a really important element during this competition.
Michaela joins Jeremy Ambojana with elite model look director Victoria De Silva to review the girls' portraits.
I think she's stunning. I think the picture is stunning. I think she's got such a strong face.
Yeah, they haven't been retouched yet at all, yes.
But how, at that age, do you give that look?
I know. How old is she?
14 and a half, almost 15. But I mean, look at that look. That's what it takes to be a model, to have something inside that speaks to you when you look at the picture. She speaks to you.
I would never give her 14 years.
That picture speaks to you. It's very beautiful.
Thank you.
Very beautiful.
And very strong.
Now, this girl is definitely a cosmetics campaign written all over her. Her hair, her skin.
Her lips.
Yeah.
That is definitely a hair campaign or cosmetics campaign. That's for sure.
That's one of the Brazilian girls.
Catherine, can I see, do you mind, Bojana, if we see other pictures of her? Because from what I see from this photo, what I see in person, she's more beautiful in person than she is in photo. And I'd like to see more, so hopefully I'm wrong. Hopefully she's as pretty in photo as she is in person.
One photo is not enough to judge a girl's performance on. Tomorrow, Bojana will reshoot with Catherine and try to bring out her true beauty. Most of the girls are taking catwalk training in their stride, and they've moved on to the next stage of learning choreography. But for US hopeful Carson, things are not going so well.
Are you trying to stretch your legs?
Yeah. Are you supposed to? Because that's what...
Yeah, you're supposed to, yes, but I have the impression you'd never wore heels.
Mm-mm.
I can see that.
I have a little difficult time on the catwalk. I've never really walked in high heels, but that's not an excuse. I need to, like, practice more standing up straight and longer strides.
You can walk slower. You can walk slower. Take your time.
I mean, Carson, the girl from the United States, I have to say, when I first looked at her, I was like, wow, she has a beautiful face. But, you know, of course, I'm seeing her on stage and, you know, everybody's, you know, stomping through and she's just like really taking a little step and walking and walking. And I have to say, if that was me, you know, I don't think I would be able to get on stage. It's really easy to give up, you know, and the fact that she did it and over again, it was really hard for her. She cannot walk and everybody was staring at her. But that shows me that she has something there to make it happen for her.
It's gonna be okay, but you need to practice.
Yes.
You need a lot of practice.
Top models need top agents, and Elite have spent nearly 2 weeks coaching young girls through boot camp. Out of over 60 contestants, only the best will be awarded contracts. With only days left, the girls must do all they can to be selected.
It's so hard to take from 62 girls, 62 amazing winner girls, and try to select 15 in three, but you know, this is our job, that's why we are here.
And others struggle with their chance in front of the camera.
She's insecure, that's one of the signs, you know.
Hopefully I'm wrong. Hopefully she's as pretty in photo as she is in person. And I'd like to see more. I think we can capture her beauty a little bit better.
They're under a lot of pressure. Of course, they're all here to win the international final. There's 60 contestants, so they have to be very focused and very concentrated. It's like any profession. Hard work and determination will make you successful.
This year, Elite has organized a real fashion shoot. To feature in a magazine, editorial pictures must tell a story.
Okay, baby, stay there. Just stay there.
Working with top photographer Bojana, the girls are asked to play a part in her creative vision.
We've given them a little abstract script saying,
imagine you're suddenly waking up and you find yourself in this unknown, weird place.
This new way of working has allowed Brazilian contestant Catherine to finally open up for the camera.
Come on! Here! You don't hear me?
Wow, did you see that Brazilian girl?
It's completely different. I think she was the biggest surprise.
Say it in Portuguese.
Vem pra cá, vem! Alessandra!
She was screaming and she was, and I literally got my attention. I'm like, my God, is she okay? But she really was acting.
Looking straight somewhere. Yes, that's very nice. Perfect.
Next in front of the camera is Italy's Sara.
Oh my God, what's this city? Why there is no one?
In my opinion, it's the best part of my life.
But the wind and sun prove it's not always easy. It's time for some harsh industry truths from Bojana to get Sara to deliver.
This is what exactly is going to happen tomorrow when you are a real model in a real shoot. Nobody would say like, oh, she cannot open the eyes, because lots of other models can open the eyes. And if you cannot, then other models would take your place.
When you're a model, you have to know how to perform. Yes, it's important that you look great, but after that, when you're on set, you have to know how to communicate with the camera.
One, two, three, open. Yes, very beautiful. Well done, brava. Okay.
With the girls improving every day, Michelangelo asks fellow agent Kwok for advice about his own girl, Gillian.
We're just gonna speak with Kwok about it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Gillian.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Like, I'm noticing you having this really beautiful line and you're walking really well and you're doing a fantastic job. But I think there's something I feel like is missing. So we were kind of like, was talking, what is it? You know, how could we make her stand out more? Mm-hmm. So one thing is, of course, it turns into your hair. You know, we're thinking maybe if we change your hair color a little bit.
I don't know, because I've never dyed my hair before.
Oh, you never have? Okay.
If I could go any color, I'd go like for the red sort of color, because
okay. Really strong red, like your Titian red, something that would be really, really powerful. Mm-hmm. I want the girl to win. I think she's really shown a great improvement and she deserves it. But, you know, I don't know if she's going to win it, but I'll try.
Also knowing how to wow the fashion world are elite models Ming Shi, Michaela Koshianova and Noemi Lenoir. Their CoverGirl careers make them ideal role models.
When you do the editorial, it seems like hard work. But when you look at the pictures, you're like, oh my God, worth it.
When you do this kind of work, you just appreciate it so much and enjoy it so much, and it was just an amazing feeling.
Now, as mentors to the contestants, sharing their elite experience is key to the girls' success.
They remind me when I was young. That's why I'm here in Shanghai, is to teach the girls how to pose, how to walk, and to be comfortable, and give them some advice. If you're smart enough, you can learn a lot.
Michaela shares her first-hand experience with Manuela.
I'm here for you guys to help
okay,
you.
Cool. You came under the top 15.
Yes. Wow. Yeah. It was kind of very hard at the beginning because I was still doing my school. But I made my school, I've done it, and now I'm working. I live in New York, and it's amazing. Wow. I love it.
You're very cool. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Sure.
Never far from her roots, Noemi homes in on French contestant Marilea. Her support will help her find the confidence she needs.
J'ai entendu que tu habitais à la campagne. C'est cool ça. Donc c'est carrément un autre monde quoi.
I was with her today, she was shooting and she starts slowly to be comfortable in front of the camera.
Wearing a modified tuxedo by Sarah Burton for McQueen, Marilea embraces the magical world of haute couture.
It's funny because you can see the difference from where she was like that. And today she was like, you know, like posing. I was like, wow.
Sharing these vintage designer pieces is private collector Susie Kellams-Dominique.
You're going to be wearing a Tom Ford for the last collection for Yves Saint Laurent. And it was based on the 1977 opium collection that Yves Saint Laurent put on himself. So it's very much a nod to Shanghai.
A dream for any model, the girls get a chance to wear dresses by Alexander McQueen, Marcel Rocha, Christian Lacroix, and Paco Rabanne.
Oh,
en portant des vêtements comme cela, on a l'impression d'être beaucoup plus importante. En fait, on a l'impression vraiment de rentrer dans un personnage parce que c'est quand même des vêtements très spéciaux. Et oui, on rentre dans la peau de quelqu'un d'autre. On n'est plus exactement nous-mêmes et du coup, ça nous donne vraiment envie de donner un maximum pour donner au mieux pour la photo.
With boot camp nearly over, it's time to let their hair down. In just a few weeks, Elite Model Look has brought together girls from many different countries. And in the biggest show of its kind, the final will soon reveal Elite's new face. UK contestant Gillian has strong ideas about how she might win a place in the top 15. With help from her agents, her look is about to get a makeover.
We picked a really beautiful red to complement her really pale white skin to her beautiful blue eyes. Cannot wait to see what the result's going to be like.
With her hair drying, the effect of the color starts to shine through.
Well done, Marlene Dietrich.
I'm really pleased with it. It's something that I wanted for like a while, so it's really nice to see it happen because it really suits me already, I think. It's quite cool that I'll be the only redhead in the competition because then I'll be able to stand out.
It looks so good. It brings out her eyes more. Ooh. She's going to be more confident with it.
With 2 weeks of boot camp now over, the four agents have taken over 60 girls through their first paces as professional models. Converging on Shanghai are agents from every corner of the Elite map, and the real business of picking a winner begins.
Today is one of the most important days before the final, because today we can see the whole package. Girls doing the catwalk, girls doing the photo shooting, girls doing a video. So these all the three things that will count.
Fresh-faced before the whole of Elite, the girls must use everything they've learned to grab the attention of the agents. The assessment now already counts towards the final. And with only 15 places to award, the search for Elite's new face has already begun.
My name is Carson, I'm 16 years old, and I'm from the small town of Tehachapi, California.
When Carson came out, she's like this adult walking on her own, so it was a really beautiful thing to see, and really happy to see that, you know, all her hard work has paid off today in front of all the agents.
Marilia is, well, I think she is a great girl. She has the personality, she's got the body, she has the right mind to be a model. So that's very important for me, very important for all the agents here. So yeah, I really believe in her.
So the best of Sarah, I think, beside the fact that she's really beautiful and full of personality, that she really wants to achieve. So this is so important to be a model because it's the characteristic of essential.
Okay, I'm proud of me. She's a girl that has the huge potential first because she's only 15 years old. She's 5'11 tall. I think she has a great photogenic as well. She does very well in pictures. Plus, she has a personality that I really like.
I could only imagine what kind of pressure they are on right now, and all these eyes, these professional agents watching them, and I could only imagine, you know, what they're going through.
We all make a decision together. We have our little fights and we have our opinions, but of course we fight for our own team, but you know, we all kind of make a conscious decision of who's going to be the winner.
Tomorrow brings the largest modeling contest of its kind, and with it, the result of the 29th Elite Model Look World Final. Today, the city of Shanghai is host to the Elite Model Look World Final. In just 10 days, 60 girls have been vying for an opportunity to become one of the agency's top new faces.
Chin down.
Already watching them are 70 agents whose final decision for this year's winner will change their life forever. But it won't be until after the last walk of the contest that they will make one of these girls' dreams come true.
is really hard. There's such amazing girls here. It's so hard to pick three. But tonight we're going to have the chance of seeing them again on a show, on a really professional show. So some opinions may change.
With everything to play for, in just 10 hours, one of these girls will become Elite's new face. Already a strong contender for a place in the top 15 is the finalist from Romania. Her height and catwalk presence have already impressed the agents.
Hello, I'm Lorena. I'm from Romania and I'm 14 years old. Beauty is happiness.
But at 14 years old, is she mature enough to cope with the focus needed by a professional?
Okay, I'm awake.
I know how I feel because this day is like the end of a part of my life and it's done, everything. You win or you're not win.
Just down the hallway is another model tip for the top. Whilst her all-round performance is looking up, her maturity has kept her grounded.
Hello, my name is Trinidad and I'm 14 years old and I'm from Chile. When I was little and I wondered what it will be when I grew up, I without hesitation say that I want to be a top model.
A mí me encanta el modelaje, ha sido mi sueño desde que yo soy chica. Y si no estoy entre las top 15, yo voy a estar triste, pero la vida sigue y yo sé que voy a poder seguir modelando.
As the girls leave for the show venue, the stage is nearly complete. Tonight's show is billed to be packed with stars. With a full house booked, the scale of the production and the part they must play in it starts to sink in.
Wow!
I think they're ready, you know. Of course they're nervous, they're all gonna be nervous, no matter how confident they are, but they are ready, that's I'm sure.
I just want you to sit in here and get a sense of scale of how big this theatre is. This is the stage that you're going to be on. So it's quite a long catwalk, so that's why we've been working on your walking so much.
With the 25-metre catwalk now complete, the girls' focus must turn to the all-important final show. A year in the planning, the 29th Elite Model Look World Final is the biggest show of its kind. All 60 contestants will walk on stage at the same time, and it's show choreographer Vicky Burns who must make sure every girl knows the routine.
And everybody pose, position. The biggest challenge for me and my assistant is we've got a lot of catwalks, so there's about 10, 12 catwalk elements in the show, and trying to get all the girls rehearsed, depending whether they're a winner or a non-winner, so they have to know two lots of choreography. So, girls, we're going to practice announcing the final 15.
Bueno, pues ha sido muy excitante porque me ha impresionado muchísimo. Porque es súper grande y nunca había estado en un sitio así. Y bueno, estoy muy nerviosa.
Even if it's hard, we have to do it because the show must be perfect. So I'm just thinking about the final show with all the audience, the lights, the music, and I just can say wow.
Biggest challenge is steps. We've built a very big stage with a lot of elements, a lot of slopes. So wearing the heels and then navigating the stage with the steps, it's not easy.
I'm about to go on the runway and walk up those crazy stairs. I'm not really sure how I feel about it. I think I'm gonna use the handrail a lot and watch my step.
Baby girl up there. Just the change from 2 weeks ago till now is just dramatic.
With only 6 hours until the curtain goes up, Ming, Noemi, and Michaela arrive to give the girls their last piece of advice and to calm their pre-show nerves.
Hi, girls.
I'm really impressed because you had 1 week to learn how to walk, and I'm really proud of you girls. Now you have to give everything you have and be powerful, and you walk it.
Girls nervous about the competition?
Yeah. We're really skinny, so we get cold really quickly. But trust me, before when you're going to be backstage, for hours you're getting ready, you're going to be cold. But just before you start, you will be hot. Trust me.
What are the absolute do's and don'ts about modeling?
You have to believe yourself. Just keep telling yourself, I can do it.
For us, teach us.
I can. Come on.
Yeah. Come on, girl.
Supporting Isabella's every step are four members of her family all the way from Holland. Whilst being the youngest in the final, at 14, she already has her sights set on the catwalk.
I'm Isabella and I'm 40 years old. For me, it's a lovely and crazy experience to be here in Shanghai.
She knows exactly what she wants and what she's doing. So I think all these experiences will be help her for the future to be a great woman.
So proud to see her walking there and, yeah, she doing it.
Very proud of her.
Best advice we can give Isabella is to enjoy this, what's happening here, and that she will always know that we stand behind her in the future, and you are a winner for us, and that's the most important thing, and a winner for herself.
The mentors know exactly what the agents will be looking for. Poise, confidence, and a killer walk that will show off the clothes. But with only one chance to prove themselves, the mentors know they can't put a foot wrong.
Celine, you're very beautiful, but you should stop moving with your head when you walk down the runway like this. Be more straight and stronger, okay?
Alexandra, I like you a lot, but to be a model, sometimes you cannot be that shy. So open yourself more, be like confident, because I think you're so beautiful.
We want to give you the final piece of advice. When you walk down the runway, try to think about something what makes you happy. Then your eyes, you know, they always say to us, smile with your eyes. Yeah. And that's happening when you think about what makes you happy, okay?
That's
yeah, and you're wearing a beautiful clothes that you love and you want to sell it. That's the thing. You need to sell the clothes.
That's what we do now.
You know?
Thank you,
girls.
Thank
you so much. Good luck to you.
With only an hour to go, there's a lot of faces to prepare.
So I have my hair done, my makeup done, something long to get dressed. So, see ya.
And for their transformation to be complete, it's vital the girls can change quickly into each of their outfits.
Now I think I'm wearing this leather jacket with these trousers.
The looks are going to evolve from casual to playful to sexy and then to really glamorous. So we're going to see the evolution of the girls. You're going to see them blossom right in front of your eyes.
When I was 3, I wore my first high heels. I stole it from my grandmother's and it was cool.
We are born for this job.
One of the most precious moments during the boot camp is the major change that happens between the girls that arrive and when they depart. I would say, really, you have the chrysalis turning into a butterfly. It's, you know, what makes our job very special. That's what we do the job for.
With the audience already taking their seats, the final result is only moments away. And with the girls' performance on the runway being the most important factor in the judges' decision, so much rests on the show itself.
Yeah, it's going to be a hard show for them, especially because it's going to be their first show, big show. They really have to be focused. They will have all these lights on them, so you'll have the music, super loud music, and the beats, they will have to keep the same beat. For the girls doing the choreography, just because you have lots of girls on stage and you have to remember where you have to be positioned, then they're going to be waiting for like their names coming up out of the speaker, and then they're going to be even more stressed out. So that's going to be really hard for them.
It's just
almost done, so.
Oh, don't cry. You're gonna be amazing.
She's starting to realize that, like, 9 of the 10 days, or like there's just one day left. It's today.
I feel nervous. I don't know how I need to speak now.
I'm excited. I'm not nervous.
Yes, you are.
Have a great time. Go have a good trip.
Good luck, okay?
Good luck.
Victoria. Why? I'm just thinking that maybe I will never see some of the girls again, you know? Like, for example, her, I was in a room with her for two weeks and I get attached to people easily. So.
You, today writing me, why you cry?
Yes. See, she doesn't even understand that she's the reason that makes me cry, because she doesn't understand English.
We'll miss her. She will miss
Victoria!
Catwalk ready, lights down, and the final is about to begin.
When the winner is going to be announced, it's going to be, for her, it's going to be, I think, amazing. And her life is definitely not going to be the same. She's going to be a model and enter the fashion world with a great background. Maybe even for us, like, yeah, the achievement of all our scouting, casting, and everything who has been done.
I think that the best moment in this competition is the moment right now, because you can feel all the energy, all the atmosphere is like getting high and it's about to start, and you feel this, yeah, energy.
Goodbye! Goodbye!
I'm not even sad. This is it!
Good luck, girls!
Coming up are the results of the largest modelling contest on earth.
Welcome to the Elite Model Look World Final.
With a stage packed with beautiful models in a show headlined by Jessie J.
The moment we've all been waiting for. The winner of the Elite Model Look World Final.